Belinda Moss is a respected pastor, author, and retired military officer. But despite all of her accomplishments, for decades, Belinda was hiding a secret. She suffered from severe depression. Getting professional help would cost Belinda her military career, so she didn't pursue it. She felt so hopeless, she thought that suicide was her only way out.
How did your depression start?
I was very young. I had a lot of insecurities, some low self-esteem. I didn't like my appearance, and I masked that because I was very smart. So I could always say the right things, and I could always do the right things, but I internalized so much. There was so much going on inside of me. I had deep, deep thoughts, always thinking about how my life was going to turn out. What was I going to do? Why didn't people like me this way and all of this? And I always felt like I had to pretend. And I often say this, I wore so many masks, even when I was little, I wore so many masks that when I would show up to different places, I would get so confused because I didn't know which mask to wear. And with all of that confusion and all of the stuff going on around me and internalizing all my thoughts, I began to get depressed.
And you know, one thing that I found very interesting about your story is you are very successful. You know, you were moving up the ranks in the military, mm-hmm. and you had a very strong, successful ministry. Mm-hmm. You were helping other people
absolutely
break through, yet you were still depressed.
Correct.
What mm-hmm. was the thing that kept you so gripped during that time?
It was my thinking processes. As soon as I would step out of that pulpit and I would get back to my hotel room, those thoughts would hit me. That black cloud would be over me. Well, what about you? You know, where's your husband? Where's your this? Where's your that? And those thoughts would so grip me and so incapacitate me that before you know it, I'm balled up, I'm crying, I'm screaming, and so on. It progressed to a point where, you know, I wanted to take my life. Life just became too hard for me.
You attempted suicide twice.
That's
correct.
The
first time you took pills.
Correct.
The second time you put a gun to your head.
Yes.
Why? And did anything change after those moments? Because obviously neither attempt was successful. You're
correct.
Here, praise God.
Correct.
But did it change anything? And what happened in that moment?
I remember that life was just so hard. It was just difficult for me. And I remember looking at those pills. And I remember saying, even though I had a daughter and I was a single parent, I just said, I can't deal with this. So I remember feeling like I didn't have an escape. So I sink further and further into depression till those pills became more appealing to me than living. So I swallowed those pills and I just lay there. And I remember there was no fear. I didn't fear whether I was going to heaven or hell. Some people, that keeps them out. I didn't have any of those fears. I wanted to end what I was feeling. I took those pills. Can you imagine how I felt when I woke up and it didn't work? So I sank further into depression with that. You know, so 2 days, 3 days, I'm deep in depression. 4 days, 5 days, I'm out. I masked it. I'm a military officer, stellar officer. I can get up and brief everybody and wow you with my tongue, you know, and with preaching. I can wow you with my preaching. But that thing in there, it was still bubbling like a volcano about to erupt. And so when I got to San Antonio, Texas, several years after my first attempt, I married someone that I thought I heard from God. It was a familiar spirit. And the things that happened to me while I was married, all it did was pour into this feeling of rejection I had. And I internalized that the reason why that happened is I must not be worth it. So the more I thought about that, and the more I thought, because it's deep thinking, I thought about it, I internalized it, and I said, I know what I'll do. Forget the pills. That didn't work. They'd pump your stomach and all of that. I began to think about a way that I could end my life. And I remember looking at that gun. It was on the shelf. And I remember looking at it. And I remember looking at it. And I walked over to that gun. And to this day, all these years later, I could feel the cold barrel in my hand. But again, that cold barrel in my hand felt better than what I was feeling inside. And I took that barrel in my hand and I put it to my head. And I remember saying, Lord, I just pray, please take care of my daughter. Just take care of my daughter. That's what I said to him. And I put the barrel to my head. When I tried to click it, it didn't go off. And when it didn't go off, then I snapped. Then it became to me, what are you doing? What are you doing? So I put the gun down, but I clicked it. I was supposed to have been gone, but for the grace of God. So it didn't happen. Now, I'm not going to tell you I had an epiphany. I didn't have a revelation, you know, that maybe it's God, you know, maybe he wants you here. He's keeping you here for such a time as this. It was just, dag, it didn't happen. So I dealt with life. I dealt with it. And I ended up divorcing my ex-husband. So over the years, what I did was I managed it. I tolerated it. I knew the cycles. I knew when they came. I knew when they went. And I just tolerated it. And I got good at it. So what happened is I met my husband, who was actually also military. And I was getting ready for a preaching engagement. And I had another bout of that depression. And so he started seeing me walk around the house. And, you know, one day I'm great, and the next day, good morning. Next day I'm looking, and you can tell that it's all internal. And it went on for a little bit. And then finally he said to me, he said, woman, you need to get a hold of yourself. You are a spirit-filled, tongue-talking woman, and you walking around here with depression, you need to do something about that. He says, you need to go upstairs and pray. So I began to pray in the Holy Ghost. So as I began to pray more and more and more, I got stronger and stronger and stronger. As I began to get stronger, then I could hear. So I got in the Word of God, and I saturated myself with the Word of God. I started putting that Word in my heart. I started seeing myself the way that God sees me. And Holly, when I tell you, when I started getting glimpses of being free, when I started thinking about how, you know, all of a sudden it's lifting, all of a sudden I'm getting some joy. You know, the scripture in Galatians 5 says that the fruit of the Spirit is joy. Well, the Spirit lives on the inside of me, so I have joy. The Spirit of God lives on the inside of me, so I have joy. So now, if depression comes, I realize that's not coming out of me. Because now I'm meditating on the Word of God. I'm living like the Word. That thing is coming against me. So now I know how to fight. And that's what I've learned to do. I've learned how to fight. So depression, the reason why I'm totally free from depression, I have annihilated depression, is I realized that Jesus took depression on the cross with Him, and He is not coming back with that depression to give to me. I know that. And I've renewed my mind to that. I've got the Word of God. So I don't have to manage it. And now I'm free. I love being free.